Aye, she met me, let me fuck in the shower. I wrote my number in the mist on the mirror. I'm not the type to tell my homies about ya. You're not the type to hold me down through the years.
Oh, wow.
I'll be
your happy baby
doll. Thursday right now.
Thursday.
Thursday afternoon.
Kicking off our weekend vlog a little early. We are headed to get my hair done. See those roots? I don't mind like a rooted look, but I don't like the straight line of it, you know? Yeah. So we're gonna see if she can blend it out. Maybe do like a rooted blonde, and then I always like my money pieces bright, but we'll see. I'll have to get the hairs did.
There's like a coffee shop next door to our hair place that I like to go to, so
yeah,
I'm just gonna chill there and work for however long, and then
long is like 3.5 hours
in Starbucks line right now.
Yeah, getting a coffee before I go in.
I made a little to go from the house
to get me through. I'm gonna get a decaf though, because we're trying to stay on the decaf game. I already had 2 regular cups today.
You try to stay on decaf after
My first one. I like to go straight to decaf, but like today I had a meeting, so I had to grab one really quick from the front, and they don't have decaf, so I've now had 2 regular cups.
See, I like,
which is just like not ideal for me. I mean, I do not need that much caffeine.
I like don't even consider decaf ever throughout my day. It's probably kind of bad. I feel like I should do that after like 1 p.m. get decaf.
I just feel like we have coffee every single day. Like, I feel like it needs to be like organic, non-toxic. Like, we need to lose some of the caffeine. It's like when it's an everyday habit, I feel like I need to take it a little more seriously.
Does the caffeine like affect you though, like throughout the day? Because I feel like for me,
I mean, if I stopped drinking coffee tomorrow, I'd get a raging headache, but
yeah,
I don't know. What coffee am I getting today? Are you getting anything?
No, I'm going to the coffee shop, yeah. So.
I don't need something to get me through. Sometimes the hot gets too cold too quick. Maybe a shaken espresso.
You look
like
you're
doing
Starbucks. How are you doing today?
Doing well. 1 second.
Could I do a grande shaken espresso with no plastic?
One more time.
Grande shaken espresso, no plastic.
A grande shaken espresso, no classic.
Decaf with almond milk.
Grande shaken espresso, no classic. What else can I do for you?
Could you do that decaf with almond milk, please?
And cinnamon powder.
For sure.
And then some cinnamon powder as well.
Decaf, almond milk, and cinnamon powder. Anything else for you?
I don't think so.
No, that'll be all.
Perfect. I need 536 with you over here.
I feel like all the boyfriends and husbands understand relaying coffee orders.
I think like it could go smoother. Like I think I could just say the whole thing and you could repeat the whole thing, but when you go and like add, and could you add cinnamon powder in? Like it makes it like so long, you know?
Yeah, well.
Like if you just said grande shaken espresso, decaf, almond milk, no plastic with cinnamon powder, like it would be.
Okay.
I don't like when they put the classic syrup in there. If they didn't put that in there automatically without telling anyone, then I wouldn't have to ask for none.
Yeah, why is that they don't tell anyone?
Sneaky. I mean, obviously it tastes better when they put classic syrup
so
in there.
Good.
But it's like sugar.
It is like straight
why
sugar.
Why do I want a turkey garbage. Bacon sandwich? That sounds so good right now.
Honestly, Starbucks has pretty good breakfast. I think.
I mean, I'd love it, but yeah. I like the spinach and feta.
What's your favorite like fast food breakfast?
McDonald's oatmeal. What?
That's so random.
You said fast food breakfast.
Yeah. I like the Chick-fil-A like.
Oh, I forgot about Chick-fil-A.
Those are so good.
I'm not used to that. Like we didn't have Chick-fil-A growing up, so it's not like ingrained in my soul.
So what are you doing with your hair today? You going blonder?
No. Smudge my root. The money piece in front. Might be going darker. And then I think I want to do like a cool toner. I like a little cooler blonde rather than like the warm blondes. I don't know.
Cooler blonde.
I have no idea.
Good.
I have no hair inspo. I have no nothing that I'm like, oh, I love that. This is what I want. That will look good on me. Like I really have no idea, so we might be just going in and asking her what she thinks. I'm definitely chopping it. Like look at this, that's going for sure. I don't know. I just never, I always leave the hair salon like liking it. It's great, it's blonde, it's whatever. But I'm never like, wow, that's gorgeous, I love it.
Yeah.
You know? And maybe it's just me. I don't, I sometimes I'm like, I don't even know what my hair looks like. I need like some more outsider opinions.
Yeah.
From girls.
Yeah, I won't be able to help much.
Yeah. So.
I need a haircut.
We'll see. I think I'll probably just ask her what she thinks. See what we want to do. After, we should definitely go to happy hour.
I'm down with that.
Yay. And then we are also applying for an apartment. Not an apartment, a house.
A house, yeah. So
rental.
We kind of got lucky. There's one that, when we went house hunting last weekend, mm-hmm. or 2 weekends ago, there was one that we really liked. And we were trying to go chase the price down, but within that time, somebody applied and it was under contract, but it recently just went back on the market. So
pop back up like literally 24 hours ago. So we're so excited, crossing our fingers that it happens.
Yeah.
Putting all the good vibes out there. I'm just like imagining myself in the space. And
hi,
yeah.
How's it going?
Going well. How are you?
Very good. 5:36 whenever you're ready. There you go.
Thank you.
Beautiful.
Thank you.
Thank you. Woo. So, very helpful about this place. I don't think like anything is ever gonna check all of our boxes. So like you gotta make compromises in some ways, but I think I like this one enough that I'm okay with not getting everything that I want. The stadium looks so cool.
I know.
The soccer stadium here. We gotta go to one. But that's what's up this weekend. It's freezing in Austin. A lot of people are without power. The roads are not great. Just kind of scary right now out. So we've been home all week. This is the first time I left the house. So just trying to stay safe and be careful.
Oh gosh.
We love it, you guys.
It looks really good.
I love it. Like she did exactly what I was imagining, but I just like didn't know how to say it or ask for it. Or like tell her what to do, I have no idea.
Yeah.
And she just like, she knew. She knew what I wanted. So a lot of people are like doing this these days. So she just did like a little low light to like blend my root out. And then she did my front money piece and then did like an ashier toner. So it definitely looks like a little darker to the eye, but we are gonna go to happy hour. It's like perfect happy hour timing.
It's 4 right now.
We're gonna whip out our laptops, wrap up work, get a snack. I'm so hungry.
I'm starving.
And yeah.
They have a good happy hour here.
Yes. And there's only Roaring Forks, I believe, in Arizona and Austin.
Really?
Yeah.
I did not know that.
Which is so weird because it's like the two places that I've lived, or two of the places that I've lived. But I love it. It's like so just like homey, comforting.
It's really nice.
It's like nothing special. It's just like steakhouse kind of vibes, I guess. I don't know.
Yeah.
But they always have a good happy hour. I used to go and get like $5 martini and $10 burger on Sunday happy hour in Arizona. I don't know if they do that anymore, but they actually have a really good burger.
They do.
And a good salad. True Fusion before in Arizona. My friend Paige has taken me. I don't know where they have locations. They're kind of sporadic, but I found out they had one in Austin and I figured I would try it. I typically do my Pilates at home. I do like the Pilates class just on my mat, or I'll do 12:30, or I'll go to F45 randomly with Dame, which is like across the street from our house, so we don't have to drive anywhere. But I can't even tell you the last time I woke up, got dressed, got ready, and drove somewhere for a workout class. This feels very weird. I was busy. Class is waitlisted, but I got in this morning. So we're doing it. I think this is like a, I don't know. maybe the 60 minute hot. It'd be a good weekend. We don't have much going on other than this I had scheduled today, and then we're going to see that one house. It's a house that we've seen before. We really liked it. We liked all the finishes and everything. It was just like a little small, but then after like we got back home and I started looking at everything again, I was like, I don't like anything else. Like, that's the only one that I like. So going to see that again. I'm running in so I'm not late. Let you know how it goes. We survived. Whew, covered my faces. That was so nice. I feel like I have been craving that for so long. It just was like sweaty and warm, and like there's something about doing like stretching or Pilates or yoga when it's hot. I don't know, it's just like the best feeling ever. So I loved it. It was so crowded. It's like the 9 a.m. Saturday class, so of course, but crazy crowded in there. They also have like a little juice bar with like snacks and stuff. That was really cute. It was like the line was so long, so I gotta get home, but I loved the class. I'm like already can't wait to come back. I have to see what like membership options are, but I just got like a one-off class today. It was like $30, so I don't know how many of those you can really do a month, but we will see. I have had like a fuzzy something stuck to my lip the whole class, but anyways, I loved it. This is True Fusion. There's only one in Austin. I think there's some in like Houston and Dallas, maybe one in San Antonio, but I mean 10 out of 10 for me. Highly recommend. Oh my god, I think I got the fuzzy thing. Oh, god bless. But what a good way to start off Saturday. I love it. I don't even know if Dame went to class. He wasn't up when I was leaving, so I don't know what time he would have gone, but it's just after 10 now. So I am going to head home, shower, make a quick breakfast, and then we're gonna go see that house again. Made it home. This is my little Pilates outfit, wearing my bar sweatshirt. Oh my god, the reflection. I can't see anything. My little bar crew neck. I love these. I always get an XL. They always go. She does like different launches. Oh, there's Dame. Of really fun colors. I'm wearing my favorite Zara vest. I got like so many compliments on this at the studio today, but I always link this in our description, my YSL sunnies. And then I'm wearing my favorite brown aloe. It's called the... Hi.
Hello. Do you know where the other keys are? Both keys?
No, you lost them. They weren't there this morning. I'm wearing my favorite brown. I forget what these are called. They're like the shiny whatever ones. But I love them. And then the matching bra with it. But cute little Pilates fit of the morning. We are on our way to the house. I sat at earlier, wanted to bring a tape measure, and I totally forgot. Heading in. One last look. Maybe apply.
Yeah, we'll take a look. We'll go to coffee, talk it over, and then possibly apply. Yeah.
See what we think.
Yeah, let's do it. We're a little late.
No, I just like every time I go in there, it's like confirmed. I love it.
I love it too. There was last time we came, there was not this dog next door neighbor like barking, and the whole time we were here just now, it was barking the entire time, which is kind of a concern for us.
Yeah, I don't do good at that.
Cause yeah, it's just get kind of annoying. But
like, imagine you're working from home all day, and this like dog won't shut up.
Yeah.
There's some storage on the back deck that we didn't get to see because the doors were locked, so I'm kind of bummed about that.
Yeah, because that's kind of a big deal.
But I mean, I feel like I probably know what it looks like. I just wanted to confirm.
Yeah. I mean, I feel like you can fit like your normal
golf clubs, paddleboards,
yeah.
Skis. Like, that's really what I was concerned about. I need a place to put those. Those are not going in the house. So that. And then the other thing was like, the bedroom that we wanted to be the bedroom, it's like maybe a little small for the king bed.
It might be a little tight. We're gonna measure. I measured it while I was in there, so we're gonna go home and measure the frame and then just kind of like,
yeah,
think of ideas that may
get the gist of it. I really want to have like a guest space. Like, I know it's like our home should not be about that, but I want to have people to be able to come stay with us.
Yeah, 100%.
And I do have too. Like a comfortable space that isn't an air mattress.
Yeah, At least like one room where they can sleep on something.
The good thing is that either way, they're gonna have a space to sleep and their own bathroom. There's also a golf course across the street. And
it's this one.
I don't know, should I look it up?
Yeah.
1619, what street are we on? Not very cute.
No, it's not.
Oh, what's with the walls?
Yeah, that's hideous.
People, just stick to like the basics. Like, it does not need to be out of this world. Like, pink walls, wood slats, and like,
I know,
crazy
like,
wallpaper. Like, can we just stick to white?
Since we've been
it's
looking,
a rental.
Since we've been looking at these new places, there's some people with some crazy ideas.
And then I'm like, do we need to be buying a rental property and like renting it out? Because I feel like it cannot be hard.
Yeah.
To beat
some of these places.
Out all these places.
That's
so ugly.
Maybe that's our next endeavor.
Honestly, should be.
Yeah, I'm down with that.
I need to talk to someone that like actually does it because for sale. Because I need to know, like, what are the struggles? What are the downfalls? What's the...
Yeah.
Obviously, owning a home is not, like...
Yeah, we need to find a really good, like, real estate friend out here.
A small thing.
Another thing that we're taking into consideration is that, this place comes with, like, all appliances. So, like, a fridge, washer, and dryer. A lot of the places that we've been looking at that we like don't include a washer and dryer. So...
You're gonna go right here.
We feel like...
Washer, dryer, or fridge.
Sometimes even a fridge, yeah.
So crazy.
So we do feel like it might even out anyways in the end because those things are not cheap.
Oh yeah, iced porchetta. Super good.
I got like a... It's like espresso vanilla
bean. I want to try yours. I don't know what the zoo is like. I'm not going to like it.
Milky for you. It's amazing. No, I was gonna ask for more once I left.
Literally a cup of milk.
No, I don't dislike Shrek. I just
Shrek is like one of the best movies of all time.
That's a stretch, man.
Shrek?
It's a stretch.
And the donkey? I really don't like Shrek, wow.
Babe, I just said I don't dislike Shrek, I just don't think it's like one of the best movies of all time. Best animated movies of all time.
Whatever. What's the best animated movie then?
How to Train Your Dragon, probably. Or... I don't know, there's a bunch out there, I just can't think. Finding Nemo. Finding Nemo's a classic.
You think it's better than Shrek?
Yes.
Really?
I do.
Shrek is so funny to me.
There's some good ones out there, animated ones.
I like Finding Nemo actually a lot, but there's just like some parts that I just like, I have to fast forward through. I get so bored.
That's how I feel about Shrek.
Oh, no, I love it.
I don't know what other animated movies I... Actually, like, have you ever seen The Croods? I used to like that, actually.
No.
But The Croods was good. Finding Nemo is like one of my favorites. Have you ever seen Shark Tale? Shark Tale is good. No, I'm saying like Shrek is probably my top five, but it's probably five.
Okay, I can accept that. We were thinking about going to Granny's Tacos. It's like a really popular taco truck here. And grabbing a quick bite before we head to the mall. We have a few little stops we need to make there, but I don't know, what do you think? Chick-fil-A, Granny's Tacos.
I'm always a sucker for Chick-fil-A. What are you in the mood for? Are you in the mood for like a Mexican?
Oh shit, I was supposed to turn there. I'm like so not paying attention.
Are you in the mood for like Mexican or are you in the mood for like a... Let's go to Granny Tacos.
Yeah, okay. Let's go, and like if the line is like out of control or something,
yeah,
we'll skip it.
Sounds good.
And get some Chick-fil-A in the mall.
Yeah.
All day.
We're gonna go, so we're going to Missouri to see our friends this coming weekend. So we thought we would just go since we have some time to get like a few things. I want to see if they have like a cool jacket I can wear out there, like a fleece or like a Carhartt or, you know, something along those lines, like a coach's jacket.
Yeah.
And because it's pretty chilly up there and I want to be...
It's cold there. I didn't realize that when we were booking tickets, and then I looked at the weather, it's like 25 degrees.
And then I also got to get like some travel stuff.
Yeah.
Maybe like a face lotion, face cleanser.
He's really been liking that Malin and Goats.
Yeah, Goats. It's a super good brand.
No idea how to say it still.
I don't know how to say it either, but
it's good. It's really cute packaging. I got him like a little travel set for Christmas in his stocking, and
I'm running out.
It's cute. You also love that little leather rollerball too, huh?
Yeah, my new little cologne.
Yep.
Travel cologne.
I like that brand. I am really wanting to go to Abercrombie & Fitch because they're having a jean sale right now and everyone like raves about their denim, and I hate ordering jeans without trying them on. So I figured I would just pop in and see what they got going on.
Yeah. Okay, there it is, little food truck. A lot of people here.
Ooh, stunning. If I didn't say already, this is Granny's Tacos on East 7th, so just right on East Side in Austin. Little food truck, very busy.
It's a little chilly outside, that's why we're eating in the car.
Yeah. What is this? Just chicken sauce?
Yeah.
Yum. Am I spilling?
No, almost did.
This is the only sauce we got?
Yeah, well, there's some in there.
With the tacos?
Yeah.
Yum. If we're bringing chips and salsa home, this is what I want.
Yeah, it's good. It's fucking hot.
Not yet. My nose will be running soon, but...
I must have got like a jalapeno or something. Or just a lot of cilantro. I don't
know. Well, the mild was like the green salsa.
Yeah.
I don't really want that.
And then we got two veggie tacos.
Yeah, with egg, potato, avocado, spinach. What else is in there? Do you remember?
Eggs, potato, avocado, spinach. I feel like that was it.
This is the veggie taco. You can get it with eggs or beans. I was feeling the breakfast vibe, so I got eggs, but I think it'd be really good with beans too.
Yeah, I was about to say, I bet the beans is good.
I like spinach. I hate like the stringiness of the ends, or when it's not like chopped.
Chopped up.
Yeah.
I feel that.
This is really good.
Mm-hmm.
Probably one of the best breakfast tacos.
Best tacos, period. I've had in a while.
Yeah. You know where we had the really good breakfast tacos? At the airport that trip.
Oh yeah.
That was so good.
Oh, it's cracking.
Craziness. Have we been here in the weekend before?
I don't think so.
We've come like really late at night.
Yeah. But we are about to see what they got. Abercrombie, Steve Madden, Nordstrom, I think those only stops. Maybe Lululemon.
Yeah. Made a quick dinner before we head out. A little pasta sitch. I whipped up a little salad and dressing. So good. Dame made us some old fashions. Be into these lately. Who knew? Never thought I would be an old fashioned girly, but it's having a moment right now. Dame got dressed. Look at his little sweater. It's my favorite. Is that the All Saints one?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I'm gonna do the hair.
Such a good buy. Your hair looks good. Did you brush it?
Combed it to the side, yeah. Cute. My hair's so wavy that if I don't comb it, it gets pretty hectic.
Yeah. Did a little sauce, put some broccoli and mushrooms in there. Woo! She's ready. And my new boots. I didn't unbox because I was too impatient, but I got these little Zara booties that I've needed. I don't have like a tan cute boot that I can wear, so we're trying them out tonight. They're a little tall, but they're cute.
They look good.
Wear my blazer as I always do. My favorite little Amazon bag, white crop top under here. Some vintage Levi's. These are a little more fitted than I normally wear. But was feeling them tonight, so fit of the night and got old fashioned in my hand. The day made that so good.
Like it?
I'm feeling them. Cute. What are you wearing?
I got on my All Saints sweater and then my these like biker jeans that I got from Urban Outfitters like a long time ago.
Yeah.
And then some All Saints Chelsea boots. So
cute.
All black.
Tee layered under the sweater.
Yeah, just like a long white tee.
Yeah. Looks good. We're going to
Neato.
We're trying a new restaurant. We're still on our new restaurant kick. And it's like a little downtown view bar.
Yeah.
I don't even know what kind of food it is. It's just really like funky and fun.
It's like American food.
Okay.
Connected to this hotel called the Lauren Hotel.
Mm-hmm.
So, I don't know. It'll be our first time, so.
Yeah, the drink menu looked good, so we're trying it out. Shall we?
Yeah, let's do it.
Okay, we haven't even made it anywhere yet, but I already decided that these shoes are a little tall. Like, can't wear these out with my short friends, which means can't really wear these out with my friends. I do love them though, they're really cute, but.
I like the way they look.
So one thing I hate about being tall, like, I love being tall, I love, like, long legs, but the one thing that I don't like is, like, when you go out to a bar and everyone's standing around, and you're just like towering over everyone. It's so uncomfortable. I can't stand it. Like I always am looking for a chair, like I have to sit. It's just like, it's so weird talking to, like looking down and talking to someone. Like do you guys feel like that a lot when you talk to like short girls? Like is that weird?
I don't know, to be honest.
You don't feel weird like looking down at?
No, I don't.
Maybe like definitely in heels. Like if I'm out in sneakers, I'm taller, like I'm okay, I'm comfortable.
I don't think guys like notice it as much.
Yeah.
Like, think about it like you would, but I've never thought of that about you before.
Mm. Not my favorite, but when it's just Dame and I on a date, sitting down.
Good to go.
I can wear these cute shoes. Potato egg bowls. So I got the potatoes and the veggies steaming in there. We're gonna top with arugula and avocado. And yeah, getting the morning started. We are, I think, going to go check out another house today. I think we're really wanting the one that we saw yesterday again, but we're going to see a few just in case the other one doesn't happen. So someone texted us back today and said they could show it to us, so I think we're gonna do that. And that is about it. I got up, ordered groceries this morning, just been hanging on the couch, have the jazz music going if you can hear it. But having a slow Sunday, Dame got a workout in at 8:45. And yeah, that's kind of the plan for the day.
We need to get you another color of that hat, though.
I want every color of this hat. I also want the 112's hat, though, too.
Yeah.
It's kind of that same style.
With the green bill?
I don't know what the style is, but I like it.
The one with the green bill, right?
Yeah.
I like that one. But we are on our way to look at another house for the moment. This guy just contacted me and was like, hey, do you guys have a minute to go see this place? And we did. So it's another place we've been looking at for the last couple weeks. So
yeah, it's been on our radar and they were just kept saying like, oh no, that's your date is too far out. But yeah. I guess they ended up not renting it. It's in a really interesting location in Austin. So we'll see about that. It's about 15 minutes from our house now.
Two bed, two bath. But the thing that we love about this one, it's like a loft. Like there's a loft in it. So
yes, how cute for an office.
So that's what drew us.
Love it.
Updated on the inside. I think it's a townhome. Like as long as we live together, we've always been like connected to people. So I think we're ready to have like our own
like
space. Yeah. But
holy traffic.
We'll see. I don't even think you gotta go through that traffic though. What do you do? I'm just kidding.
We had so much fun last night.
Yeah, Nito was 10 out of 10.
Amazing.
Probably like one of my top three spots that I've been to since I've been here.
I really like it. It's just like the vibes are right. The city view was so cute. The drinks were so good. Like having a good drink menu of things that like I actually want to try and order.
Yeah.
So nice.
And for what it was, I thought the drinks were fairly priced. Like
Just regular priced,
like going out to dinner drinks, like. I've been to like places here that were more than that place, and definitely not as nice or vibey.
Oh my god, do you remember when we went to Howard's?
Oh my god, we spent like $70.
How much were those espresso martinis?
$20.
$20 for a draft espresso martini, not even like a handshaken. Fresh espresso cocktail. No,
$20. It was so bad too. It wasn't even good.
For a draft, like milky. But yeah, highly recommend.
Yeah.
Nito. They have like a whole little lounge area. There's like the restaurant side and then the lounge side, which has like, they didn't have very many bar seats.
No, there's only like 6 bar seats.
Like 4 or 6, yeah. But then they had a bunch of like lounge couches and like little like one-off tables that you can just grab.
Mm-hmm.
So I would recommend just like, you probably don't need a reservation.
No, if you're gonna just get drinks, you don't need a reservation, like drinks and like bar bites. Yeah. But if you're gonna eat dinner there, you'd probably wanna get a reservation.
So does the dinner side have the city view? Are there windows over there?
There was windows over there, yeah.
Okay. You could probably reserve, a table with the view, that'd be so nice.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think, I mean, it was, last night we went, it was Saturday night at like, what, 8:30?
8:30. Almost 9 actually.
And there were definitely like lounge spaces for us to grab.
Yeah.
Lounge seats for us to grab, so. But it was still really busy.
It was so busy. It
seemed like the bartenders and servers were running around, so.
The service was really good too, I would say.
Service was amazing. They checked on us like no other.
Yeah.
Very like teamwork style. We love that.
Fair.
It's also a fun place, yeah, like if you're visiting to go get a like pre-game cocktail or something.
Yeah, because it's so close to everything else.
It is.
Okay, that house was, it was cool, but it was not our favorite.
No, it just seemed like old. You know when people like cover up, they're like, they try to do remodel, but it still seems like old and just like not well done. It
seemed like really old. The only thing the only thing that we did love was the loft.
Loft was so nice, like, because it's two bed, two bath, right?
Yeah.
Two bed, two bath with a loft. And the loft was, like, so dreamy for an office space. Like, it had big windows up there. It just would have been so nice, but it's definitely not happening. It's also far out of town. It's, like, the same price as somebody that we're looking at in town.
Yeah.
It's just, like, there are a bunch of reasons, but.
Yeah.
Anyways, cross that off our list.
Look at the doggies. Look at the doggies.
Up on a little walk. James got his wine.
Good evening, folks.
Sunday walk. Back at it again.
Sunday happy hour.
Sunday happy hour. Got a little wine. I didn't feel like carrying one, honestly.
Whoa.
So. But whoa. I might have an Olipop when I get back. This one's really good.
What flavor? We got orange and.
We have orange
vanilla,
and.
Vanilla. Strawberry vanilla.
Is that the two that we have?
Yeah.
Okay.
I say you do strawberry.
Orange is so good. You know what's so good that I don't remember if we had on the vlog or not, but the cream soda one?
Fire.
So good.
Top. Probably the number one spot in the Olipop to me.
Cream soda?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's so good.
The orange cream used to be so good. They don't make it anymore. Boo. But I did see that Costco's doing like a 6 or 8 pack or something.
Nice.
Yeah. I have the hiccups.
Beautiful evening out today.
Ooh, it's so nice.
Very calm.
Loving it. Feels good. We're in back in like some normal clothing, regular weather.
Yeah.
No longer like winter storm warning.
I was telling Tay that this weather right now reminds me of like a summer night in Alaska.
In Alaska. This is like Alaska summer weather.
Yeah.
So funny.
Look at all the fishermen.
Yeah, there's even people on the water today. So she's warming up. Been having a very productive Sunday. Kind of loungy on the couch. I finished editing a vlog. Been watching vlogs. Yeah.
Sunday
been
night.
Crushing the laundry today.
Sunday night festivities, laundry, cleaning up, eating out.
Olipop.
Olipop, wine.
Wine.
A show.
Jack Ryan, for sure.
Yeah.
We're on, like, what are we on? Episode?
Episode 5, I think. It's early.
I like it.
Yeah.
Fulfilling my, like, FBI, CIA TV show craving. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I feel you.
It's been good. But figured we would end the vlog here. End of the weekend. It was fun. Had a great date night. Did some good productive Sunday stuff.
Yeah.
Been pretty relaxing. I've enjoyed it.
It's been a good weekend.
Yeah.
Nice and relaxing.
But gonna have a great week. Probably take you along this week while we get ready for Missouri. And then
yes.
We will also kick off a Missouri vlog on Friday.
Yes.
But we'll see you soon. Everyone has a great week. Bye.
Honey. Whoa, keep it up, Gavin.
Baby, are you up right now? Let's talk, meet me in the upside down. Being with me got a lot of upsides now. Got a lot of upsides now. She don't wanna sing, she wanna sing.